Dairy is an important food group for most people because it contains calcium which helps strengthen the bones. Some examples of dairy are milk, ice cream, yogurt, and cheese. Cheese is made out of milk that came from cows, goats, sheep, camels, etc. It is also made out of milk fat, cream, water, and lactic acid bacteria, which curds the milk and makes the cheese more acidic. Cheese is yellow because of the anatode seeds, which is the food coloring. The pigment in anatode has the same structure as beta carotene. Enzymes are needed to produce cheese such as rennet, lactase, catalase, lipase, and protease. Lactase breaks down lactose into sugars. Catalase is used in Swiss cheese because it preserves original enzymes from the milk that can help improve the cheese's flavor. Lipase breaks down milk fats that can enhance the flavor of the cheese. Protease breaks down proteins in the milk. Rennet is made out of different enzymes that can break down the proteins in milk, and it comes from the lining of the cow's stomach. It has enzymes like renin, aka chymosin. Renin is also an enzyme in rennet that came from molds, which gives the cheese a slightly bitter taste and curdles the milk. These enzymes are used to coagulate the milk, which allows the proteins to be digested in the stomach. A protein that is found in milk is casein. There are four types of casein: alpha S1, alpha S2, beta, and kappa. Casein is mainly hydrophobic, but kappa also contains hydrophilic components in it, which is later converted into hydrophobic molecules by renin. It is important for casein to be converted into hydrophobic molecules because it helps trap fats and water molecules to produce the curds. It also helps for water to be removed when compressing and forming the cheese. Another ingredient that is needed is bacteria, such as mesophilic bacteria, which is used in room temperature and produces soft cheese, and thermophilic bacteria, which is used in high temperature and produces sharp cheese. The bacteria can be separated into two groups: primary and secondary microflora. Microflora are bacteria, small fungi, and algae. Primary microflora contains lactic acid bacteria that converts milk to cheese through fermentation. Secondary microflora are yeast and molds that are used for certain types of ripened cheese. With all these ingredients, the milk goes through a process called cheese fermentation. During this process, lactose in the milk is converted to lactate. Cheese fermentation occurs due to the presence of starter cultures of lactic acid bacteria, which contains enzymes to break down the lactose and convert it into lactic acid. Fermentation happens after glycolysis, when there is no oxygen. The pyruvate goes through fermentation and oxidizes NADH to continue the process of glycolysis to convert NADH to NAD+, so that it can be recycled, which continues glycolysis. Fermentation in cheese is important because it preserves nutrients and increases the acidity, which prevents the cheese and milk from spoiling quickly and growth of harmful bacteria. The equation of cheese fermentation is lactose plus water equals lactic acid. The first step of cheese fermentation is preparing the milk. You heat it up to kill the harmful bacteria through the process of pasteurization. This is the process of heating a liquid to a certain temperature and time, then letting it cool down. This causes the growth of bacteria in cheese to slow down. The milk is then treated with bacteria and rennet to convert the lactose in milk to produce the lactic acid in cheese. The increase of acidity decreases the pH level of milk, which causes the solidification of casein and whey. Casein is a milk protein which coagulates into curds, which traps most fats, calcium, bacteria, etc. Whey is a liquid that contains water, proteins, antibodies, and minerals, which forms during the coagulation of casein and becomes a waste product. The second step of cheese fermentation is separating the curds from the whey. The addition of the enzyme rennet will continue the separation of curds and whey. Rennet is mixed into the milk and continues to separate the curds and the whey. They are soaked with bacteria, creating a concentration of lactic acid. After, salt is added to the curds, which affects the flavoring of the cheese. When the curds are formed, it is cut with knives. The size that the curds are cut affects the texture and moisture of the cheese when storing it. The third step of cheese fermentation is pressing the curds. It is first pressed gently to allow the additional whey to be drained, and then uses heavy pressure to give the cheese a solid form, removing the moisture in the cheese. They are then put into molds to give the cheese a nice shape. The fourth step of cheese fermentation is letting the cheese age. Cheese is aged for a series of time which can last for days, weeks, months, and even years for it to ripen in a cool environment, enhancing the taste of the cheese. The average temperature of the environment is 10 degrees Celsius. Proteins, fats, and sugars continue to change in the cheese by enzymes and bacteria. However, Swiss cheese has holes due to the P. Schirmani bacteria. Using this bacterium will produce CO2 in the cheese, which creates the holes. This concludes the process of making cheese. The energy that is used in producing the cheese is heat energy, used to kill the pathogenic bacteria. Kinetic energy is used to mix up the curds and whey, and electrical energy is used to cool down the cheese and use it for machinery. The risk of eating cheese is causing abdominal discomfort to the people who are lactose intolerant. This condition occurs when an individual does not produce enough lactase enzymes in their small intestine to break down lactose. Symptoms are bloating, cramps, diarrhea, vomiting, and rumbling of the stomach. Lactose intolerant individuals can take lactase supplements to help break down lactose, or they can avoid dairy products. They can eat soy cheese because it is not fermented and it does not contain dairy and lactose. The risk of producing cheese is that dairy gets spoiled quickly because it contains microorganisms in it. Milk also contains many harmful bacteria that can cause food poisoning. The milk can get contaminated with cow manure, bacteria from the cow skin, and unsanitary equipment and machinery. However, pasteurization is a method of heating up the milk to decrease the growth of pathogenic bacteria, which reduces the health risk. But if the milk is heated up to a very high temperature, the enzymes will denature, and the milk will not be able to convert into cheese. Cheese is not beneficial to the environment because it increases the greenhouse gases in the environment by the uses of factories, transportation, and packaging of the cheese. Certain types of cheese can also increase the CO2 levels. Raising cows will increase the methane due to the manure. To decrease these effects, farmers are encouraged to change the diet of their cows and to convert the manure into electricity with the use of methane digesters. Getting the milk is considered torture for the cows. According to PETA, an organization that campaigns for animal rights, state that female cows are constantly injected with hormones and full of antibiotics that can produce more milk. A PETA investigator also stated that cows from dirty factories are suffering and neglected due to bleeding, hostile naming, and electrocution. Even though dairy production has its disadvantages, it also has its benefits. Cheese is beneficial to society because it creates many new job opportunities. Some jobs that are related to cheese is becoming a chef, factory workers, advertising, transportation, bioengineering, etc. Cheese also allows people to have more a variety of food and recipes like cheesecake, mac and cheese, chips, pizza, etc. And that concludes our video of cheese fermentation. Thanks for listening, you are a great audience. Don't let your cheesy knowledge turn into waste.